Hello and welcome to another vlog. April was filled with natural transformation and garden projects for our new house. One thing that we wanted to do this year was to make these awesome garden beds for our little porch. We have a lot of wildlife visit us, including deer and raccoons, so we wanted to make sure that our precious garden wouldn't be eaten by the wildlife. So we crafted these garden beds inspired by another YouTuber. I'll put the link to the video in the description below. And yeah, we really enjoyed making these together, and we're staining them right now. It just so happens that the color of stain we picked matched the color of our house. Over the years, I've been collecting seeds, and this is my treasure chest filled with them. I have thousands of different seeds and varieties, and I've been saving them for the perfect time, which is now, when I can have my own garden. I wanted to plant wildflowers and flowers all over the place, despite there already being lots of flowers in the yard. So I planted wildflower seeds along the edge of our pasture here to create a nice edge of frilly flowers. Here I'm planting some Shasta daisies, and my hope is that they'll just be able to come up. I'm a huge advocate for permaculture gardening and the Ruth Stout method of gardening, aka the lazy gardener. And it's not so much that I am lazy, which I totally am a lazy gardener. It's more so of just letting nature do all the work for you. And there's so many ways that we can allow this into our lives, so many ways that we can allow nature to just do all the work for us. We don't need to struggle and work so much to accomplish anything, because nature really does provide us with all we need. Here I am taking the garden beds that are already here, and I'm putting a layer of sheet mulch onto them. Sheet mulch has been super successful for me in the past. If you are interested in seeing how I turned a desert into a luscious garden, you could go back to my permaculture playlist and check out some of the videos from when I lived in Arizona. It was quite the task to turn that place into a luscious garden oasis, but it was possible and it could be done. And I did it through this Ruth Stout lazy gardener method. Our garden beds dried. We put them in the stable so they would dry without getting wet. And now we're just taking them out and putting them up on our deck. We made two tall beds and we made two potato boxes. The idea with the beds is the shorter one will be for greens and things with shallow roots, while the deeper garden bed is for things with bigger roots, like root vegetables, onions, and even tomatoes and cucumbers. The potato boxes, the idea is you fill it a third of the way with soil, you plant your potatoes, and then as the potato plants grow, you add more soil on top of it. And along the central stem of the potato plant will grow a massive amount of potatoes. So when the potatoes are ready to harvest, you'll be able to just reach in and grab handfuls of potatoes. In our standing beds, we put a layer of paper down first on top of the landscaping fabric to kind of hold everything in. And then we got some compost from a local farmer to fill the beds with. I planted some cilantro in little containers, and I'm just planting it in our standing beds now. And while I do that, Austin is down in the garden getting all the cardboard wet that I laid down on our garden beds. The cardboard is biodegradable and attracts worms and other microbes in the soil to begin breaking it down. The plants will also break down this material when they grow bigger and that sort of thing. We're doing a super simple method of sheet mulch where we just do the paper and cardboard on the bottom, then a compost layer on top of that, and then I am putting the old bedding and straw from inside of the stable on top as a layer of mulch. Now, if we got animals, we would most likely have to clear out the entire stable, and I really am not sure how old this bedding is, but I'm assuming that it's pretty old based on the amount of wildlife droppings that was in it. So I feel like it's the perfect medium to put on top. And the plan with this part of the garden is to grow bigger crops like zucchini and squashes, pumpkins, perhaps even corn. Another project that I was working on all month was rock tumbling. I am exploring new mediums of earthen art, or art that comes directly from the earth, and tumbling stones and making them polished and shiny is a really cool activity to learn how to do. This is how my stones turned out. Some of them are local from my area in Wisconsin, some of them I found along the way on our travels, and others came with the rock tumbling kit. So here I'm just putting in the last polish for the rocks, and they'll be done in another week or so. But so far, they're looking pretty awesome. Besides for gardening, we've been doing a lot of hiking and exploring in our local area. I've been really interested in the mounds, so we've been visiting a lot of parks that contain the Indian mounds from ancient times that are perhaps maybe more than what they appear to be. I have some vlogs about mounds available on my channel if you want to learn more about this. But this is just the beginning of something new, I feel. Austin's birthday was at the end of the month, and I wanted to make him a special cake for his birthday. We really like following a plant-based diet, and we recently got a new cookbook. I will put the link for it down in the description, but in the cookbook is this raw vegan pistachio rose cheesecake, and my oh my, did it turn out to be quite the delicacy, let me tell you. I started out with a date and almond crust. Next, I have a pistachio cashew cream, and it's bright green from the little bit of spirulina that gets put into it. And then it gets topped with another layer of cashew, but also rose. It's infused with roses. Oh, and it was so delicate and flowery and very much a spring delicacy. I wanted to add some wildflowers to the top of it, so I went down into the strawberry patch. We have this lovely strawberry patch on one end of the yard. It is just literally filled with strawberry plants, and in between those strawberry plants are violets. So I took my basket down and I went to pick some violets. I always love incorporating nature into everything that I do, and I love finding simple edibles that I could use to add to my food. Our property is just loaded with wild edibles. I discovered we have wild plums here, we have a few apple trees, there's tons of raspberries and blackberries, there's strawberries, and don't get me started on all of the wild greens around. But for now, we're just going to use the violets to garnish the cheesecake and to make it look more springy and beautiful. Austin really did enjoy his birthday and this cake. It was such a fun time. We always have so much fun together. I'm so grateful that we were able to create this life and were able to live in this beautiful place. Well, that's all for this month's vlog. Thank you so much for watching and for spending a little bit of time with me. Sending you all the love and light in the world. Bye!